Hi there! Today we are unboxing this box from Mosaic, so let's get started. Last week I ordered the Pallet Plus from Mosaic. This is a unit where you can print multiple filaments on one printer. And it's not just on one printer, you can use it on nearly every printer you have, as long as it supports 1.75mm. Luckily, nearly all my printers are 1.75mm, so that's great. Today we are looking at the box itself. In one of the next videos we will be installing it on the CR10. So, let's get started and have a look in the box. I haven't looked at it myself as well, so it's all new for me, so I don't know what's in there. I just opened it and that's it. So, here we go. It's a really nice and sturdy box itself. So, the first thing we get here is a quick start guide. Within this quick start guide, there is a nice piece of paper that explains that it's quality controlled. It did the splice test and it passed quality control on the 14th of February this year. It also has the serial number. In the back is some nice text from Mosaic, which is great. It's a sort of personal touch. It's not completely personal as it's not named, but it's nice. So, let's have a look further in the box. First, there is another box in the box. So, let's get it out and have a look. The first thing is a nice rod. It's probably part of the spool holder. It's nice, strong and metal. Here we have the power brick with a European power cord, which is great as I am in the UK. It's a Meanwell power brick, so it's a high quality brick. Then we have a USB cable, which is fairly standard. A few pieces of Velcro to mount the stepper, which is here. So this is the stepper. It has a piece of Velcro in the back and it's really nice. It also contains the magnet at the end. So, then we have a piece of filament. I think that's used for calibration. Next, we have a simple hex drive. Probably not going to use it because I have much better tools. Then we have a piece of tubing. I'm pretty sure that's for the internals. We have a Mosaic grounded SD card. And a few printed parts, which is again for the spool holder, I think. We have a really nice sticker. A few screws, it looks like, or something like that. They are hollow and plastic. It's probably not visible on the camera. And we have a 3D printed part again with a piece of Velcro to mount it on top of the printer. I'm not going to use it as I'm using it on the CR10 and that's mounted differently. Lastly, as I ordered the Pro package, it's also included here. And that contains a few extras. First, again, you get an extra sticker. Really important. Then, you get some extra blades for the cutter. These are a few PTFE tubes, extra, one outgoing, two merges and four splices. So if you need it, really handy. This is one spare fan for it. A few extra bits and nuts and what cable ties. So that's included, not with the normal pallet, but it's a Pro package, which I think you pay $45 or something for that. I especially bought it for the extra PTFE tube because these are special and for the extra blades. So now let's get this cleared and have a look at the rest of the package. So here we are again at the box. As you can see directly, here is the unit. So let's get it out. It is mounted really sturdy in the box, so I'm going to do this offside camera to make it easier. So this is the unit. This is the bottom side, so you're going to see that first, sorry. You can see a few nice CE marks designed in Canada and a few things like that, so that's nice. And now let's turn it the other way around. Here you see the unit itself. So the display where information is provided, I button, and here at the other side the inputs. So the very first step in the quick start guide is setting up your pallet. And it's actually not using a printer to test some stuff, but testing the splice mode. So we are going to dry it. They are suggesting to use two or four spools, so I'm going to use two for now because that's the colors I have here around. And we are going to try that. So we are going to start up the unit, power it on, load a few filaments, and let's see how it's going. So we have everything needed to do these first steps. We have power here with the power cable, we have the needed SD card, and we have three spools of filament. So let's put in the SD card, and that's right here at the side. Put in the power connection and it should start up. So there it is. The first thing it says, go to splice demo. That's the second option here. And then without printer. So then we have three spools of filament. And now it's telling us to load filament one. And that's loaded, so now we need to load filament two. And lastly, load filament 3. As you can see, I have three rows of filament here within the box, and that's a really nice feature. You can use the box as spool holder for this. So, currently it's doing splices. It's heating up and it's going to do 200 splices. So let's see how this works out. I've learned directly one thing. I have put in the spool box, the spools in the wrong way around, because they are now going the wrong way. They are feeding in from the bottom, so that's not handy. So for the next time, I need to make sure that's switched. It's going to heat up to 230 degrees Celsius. So I'll see you in a bit when it's heated up and everything is working. So while waiting, I've switched around the spools to make it easier to spool down. So that's a great thing. Make sure your spool holder is correct mounted, otherwise it's really going to be painful. Also, the thing I'm noticing that there is a pretty loud fan, which is also providing a lot of cool air, which is probably good, but I'm not sure if I like the loudness, but we'll see when it's using on a CR10. It's now 217 degrees, so it's probably going to start soon. And you probably can't see it on the camera, but here near my finger, the first piece of filament is coming out. And I'm seeing the first flies over here, and it's, yeah, probably not visible on camera at all. The first part is black, that was the first color I'm using. The second part seemed to be white, and yeah, that seems logical. It's still not fully on temperature, it's around 225 degrees Celsius, but it seems to be doing the job fine. You can see here, it's just outside reach of camera, I guess. Which is, you can see here the filament coming out. So, I will let it running and come back by to you when it finished with everything. So, see you in a bit. As you can see here, we have a lot of filament, which is nicely colored. Yellow, black and white. It came out great. The first few splices were okay, after that it worked much better. I will be using this filament and I will probably use another spool for some nice prints. So, in the next video, we will be installing the Pellet Plus on the CR10. So, hopefully see you then. Goodbye for now. So, thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe if you haven't already. And please like this video. It helps the channel a lot. If you want to watch another video, please click here.